إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising children at this time is one of the most challenging mission that faces a Muslim who cares about his deen, a Muslim who cares about his akhirah, his hereafter, a Muslim who believes and realizes that the children are ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he bestowed upon you. قال الله تعالى لله ملك السماوات والأرض يخلق ما يشاء يهب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور أو يزوجهم ذكرانا وإناثا ويجعل من يشاء عقيما إنه عليم قدير. To Allah belongs what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. He owns it all. He bestows upon whom He wills females, and He bestows upon whom He wills males, and sometimes both, and sometimes He makes some of us barren, not having children. A lot of us as parents do not realize that the children are a bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you really want to find out, ask those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made barren. Ask them. They would tell you that they would love to pay whatever it takes to have a child. They are ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if I may kindly ask you, we see a lot of gaps and the brothers are filling in the back. Can we just move forward? And it's the sunnah that we come closer to one another, inshallah. So we allow the brothers to. Barakallahu feekum. Raising children, brothers and sisters, in Islam at this time is one of the most challenging mission that faces a Muslim who believes that his children are a responsibility, that he will be asked in the day of resurrection regarding what he did with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believers saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. O ye who believe, O parents, ward off, protect yourselves and your children from a hellfire, the fuel of which people and rocks. This hellfire is guarded by angels who are stern, severe in look and in acting. They disobey Allah not, and they do what they were commanded to do. قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم والحديث متفق عليه في الصحيحين حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. All of you are custodian, shepherds, and in the day of resurrection you will be asked about your custody. الرجل راع في أهل بيته والمرأة راعية في بيت زوجها. A man is in charge for his household, for his children. You are responsible, and in the day of resurrection, you will be asked regarding your responsibility. What did you do with it? Your son, if you have not taught him the salah and implemented hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عَلِّمُوهُمْ لِسَبْعَ وَاضْرِبُوهُمْ لِعَشْرٍ. Teach them at the age of 7. Give them a little spanking at the age of 10. If they do not pray, he will hang in your neck and say, why didn't you teach me? Why didn't you fulfill what Allah commanded you to fulfill? Brothers and sisters in Islam, your children are amanah. أمانة. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون. O ye who believe, betray not Allah, betray not the messenger, betray not your entrusts while you know. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named two of them. وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ. Your wealth, your children are a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. Subhanallah, هذا الحديث حديث البخاري حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كل مولود يولد على الفطرة. Every newborn is born on the fitrah. Abu Huraira, at the end of this hadith, اقرأوا إن شئتم فطرة الله وفطرة الله هي الإسلام فطرة الله التي فطر الناس عليها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically given to you a Muslim in a form of a baby. Baby Muslim. Yes, he's a Muslim. كل مولود كل صيغة جمع. Every newborn يولد على الفطرة. He is born a Muslim. Now, فأبواه. Then his fathers, his parents. I want to include the mothers, they are his parents. That's the word that I should use. His parents. يهودانه. يهودانه. They will take him from Islam to Judaism. أو ينصرانه. Or they take him to Christianity. أو يمجسان. والتمجيس, all the other false deities. لم يذكر في هذا الحديث أو يسلمان. In this hadith, no. He was given to you a Muslim. Now your job is to continue with his Islam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising children at this time is one of the most challenging mission that faces a father who realizes the consequences of not fulfilling that amanah. There are consequences. Beside your child hanging in your neck in the day of judgment, قل say ya Muhammad sallallahu ala Muhammad. Tell them, ya Muhammad. قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. You want to know a manifest loss, here it is, that you lose your family in the day of resurrection, even if you go to Jannah, and your child ends up in the hellfire. And subhanAllah, في هذه الدنيا, in this dunya, when your child temperature just goes up a little bit, you panic. You go to the doctor because he has a temperature. Can you imagine your son or your daughter going to the hellfire? Have you ever thought about that? Ever thought about it? That your child goes to the hellfire, a fire that blackened and whitened and prepared. Also, brothers and sisters in Islam, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the other side of this. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ كُلُّ امْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ. If you have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you have raised your children to be believers, you will be together in Jannah. Can you imagine you will be with your family in Jannah? Where you don't get sick, where you don't get ill, where you don't even get bored, where you don't even get angry. You are in a state of felicity all the time. Don't you dream all the time of having a peaceful home? Jannah. But all you have to do is die with iman and make sure that your children carry on that iman after you leave this world. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the loss is not only in the hereafter. The loss is here in this dunya for a parent who fails to raise his children in the way of Islam. They will not be dutiful to you. And subhanAllah, if this Quran is amazing, read the verses that talked about the command to the children to be dutiful to the parents. You will find it immediately in sequence after teaching the children Tawheed. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Dear father, dear mother, if you fail to teach your children about Tawheed, about Allah, if you were a reason for these children to waste haqqullahi ala al-ibad, the right of Allah on his servants, they will waste your right. They will not be dutiful to you. They will not. They will not. Illa man rahima rabbi. Add to this, ya akhi, ba'd al-maut. Yani all of us, look at the loss after you leave this world. All of us, once we talk about doing something for the deceased, sadaqa jariya or knowledge, we always forget about the first one. Idha mat ibn Adam, or idha mat al-insan, and both wording are authentic. If the son of Adam dies, in qata'a amaluhu illa min thalath. You go into the graveyard, khalas. No more good deeds come to you. Accept three sources. One, waladun. Did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, waladun yad'u lah? La, restricted. Waladun salihun yad'u lah. If you want your child to make dua for you, contribute to the righteousness and piety. Billahi alayk, if you do not bring your child to the masjid, if your child does not see you praying, if your child does not see you reciting the Quran, if your child sees you lying, if your child sees you stealing, he's going to be a salih. Where is he going to get his salah from? His righteousness from? Brothers and sisters in Islam, we all act so much concerned about the ummah. And I'm sorry to use the verb act, but the majority of people are acting it. That they care so much. Look at the Muslims here, there and there. أخي إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. الله سبحانه وتعالى will not, will never. هذه سنة ربانية أخي, سنة, سنة ربانية. Something that Allah already decreed. Allah will not condition, Allah will not change the condition of a community until they change from within. That means I change my inner self, and then I change my family, and then you change your home. I change my home, I change my home. Then the community of Abu Bakr will change. Then the community of An-Nur will change. Then the community of Boulder will change. Then the Washington State will change. Then Egypt will change. Then the Ummah will come together. يقول لك احنا عايزين مش عارف الخلافة والخلافة يا على مين؟ Who? On whom? يا أخي سبحان ربي سورة في كتاب الله. A surah in the book of Allah. سماها أهل التفسير بسورة التمكين. The people of tafsir called it the surah that explains how to be empowered in earth. وعلى فكرة أنا ما بقولش empowered in earth إن إحنا we're gonna shoot everybody down. يعني تمكين المسلمين يا أخي, Muslims being empowered to serve humanity. سورة القصص. Listen to this. وهذا قرآن. ونريد. We know that Bani Israel at the time of the Pharaoh were the Muslims. And some of you now, yes, أخي, it's been Islam always. And they were oppressed by the Pharaoh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ونريد. We want. أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة. We want to empower those who were oppressed in earth and turn them from oppressed to leaders. ونجعلهم الوارثين and make them inherit earth. ونمكن لهم في الأرض and to empower them in earth. ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما منهم ما كانوا يحذرون. What are we going to do? Allah wants to empower Bani Israel in earth. Here is how it's going to happen. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. واحد يقول لك لسه هترضع. Breastfeed the mother of Musa, breastfeed your baby, Musa. He is the one who will do all of this. How many years, أخي, between this, between what Allah said and when Musa went to Madian, spent 10 years, came back, and then he came back to Egypt. يقول أهل التفسير 40 years. 40 years. But here, if you want the Ummah to change, you have an asset in your home, your child. Prepare your child. Bring him up as a Muslim. It is very challenging. I agree. Wallahi, akhi, I'm a parent myself. I'm a father. Very challenging. Because of so many reasons. But I just want to share with you just two. Number one, you're not alone. يعني يقول لك متى يبلغ البنيان يوما تمامه إذا كنت تبني وغيرك يهدم. When a building will be constructed, when you construct and then somebody comes and destroys. You're not alone. Your child now, you know a tree? The tree, once it grows, or it has a lot of roots in the ground, and it sucks a lot of nutrition. Right now, your child gets influenced by the internet, by the TV, by the neighbors. Bye. You're not alone. And bringing up children is a process that takes three main. There are a lot of branches, but three main. A home, a masjid, a school. And if you lack one of those, insa. A home. is the beginning of that child. Yani, subhanallah, and I really feel for myself and for you. You know, to bring up a child in Islam begins before you actually have a home. Before you actually marry. Before you marry. Tabillahi alayk. When you married your spouse, and I'm not going to distinguish wives and husbands, have you ever thought that man or that woman will be parents for your child? حتى هذه يقول لك لماذا؟ Why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say في الحديث بتاع البخاري و others, a woman تنكح المرأة لأربع. A woman is asked for marriage because of four incentives. مالها, her wealth, جمالها, her beauty, وحسبها, her lineage. And with the lineage now comes the green card and her green card, her lineage. And then وَدِينِهَا, and then her deen. فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكَ. Why? Because you're really, in reality, you're choosing a mother for your child. كثير من الناس الآن, سبحان الله, fathers, they go and get married based on other incentives than this. And then, سبحان الله, Allah cast into their hearts, once he sees that child into this world, now I want my child to be a Muslim. And I want, and then he goes to the mother, can you help me? No. ما على هذا تزوجنا. I did not marry you to place me in that jail. Let's go to the club, your wife. ما ينفع. تاخد ابن المسجد تعلم الارهاب. My son, you won't teach my son terrorism? لا. I'm not saying that we do that, but that's... The other thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the fact that you're not alone, as I said, in this dunya. Your child gets affected. That, here it is. We are not aware that we have a curriculum in Islam that can help us bring up our children in the way of Islam. Ya akhi, my brother, my sister in Islam, I just want to give you one page. Go and study it. The second page in surah called Surah Luqman. Surah Luqman. One page in the Quran. If you study that page and if you implement what's in it, you will have a Muslim child. Inshallah. A believing one. So, the second reason that we became unaware somehow, somewhat, that we have what I would say a curriculum that can help us bring our children as Muslims. Because we are negligent, and I'm not being negative, you know, I don't want to sound negative to you, wallahi. I'm just trying to help out. Because we are negligent of learning it, negligent of teaching it, then what we go and adopt the lifestyle of a non-Muslim and apply it to our Muslim children. خلاص. ما ينفع. But you have, أخي, you have generations that were the produce of that curriculum. And they ruled earth. Allah empowered them in earth in a time that is a record time. يا أيها الذين آمنوا, O ye who believe, قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة. Protect your children and yourselves from the hellfire, the fuel of which is human and rocks. What is the solution? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it's never late. Never late. And by the way, never give up. And this is the beauty of this deen. But you must begin now. And you know the first thing that you need to begin with is your intention. You must believe in the depth of your heart that your children, as I said at the beginning, are responsibility, are amana, are a bounty, and that you are to fulfill, you are required, is not optional, to fulfill these rights. And do it for Allah. Yani some of our parents, they just want to be proud of their children. Even once it comes to the area of the hereafter, they bring them to the masjid to learn some surahs, and their intention is what? You know my son? Come here my son. Recite. He just want to show the, لا يا أخي ربي ولدك لله ربيه لله. Bring up your child for Allah, not for the people to show off with him. No أخي والله لو أخلصت لربك لرزقك الله كل هذا. If you do it for Allah, Allah will still give you this. You will be proud of him. This is number one. Step number one. What is your intention? What was your intention? Were you trying to do this just to show off? Look at my son. لا لله لله. Two. توكل على الله. One of the sisters in the last Sunday, she asked me a question saying, why should we have children at this time when the percentage of them going astray is way up there? I mean, she's you cannot protect your child anymore from anything. Just going into the internet, checking your email right now, who? Astaghfirullah. And they have emails. Look at the phone now. You can send all type of things. It's amazing. But أخي ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه. أنا أسوق لكم أمثلة حية. And I want to give you examples, living examples. يعني سبحان الله وإن كان هذا يعني من الإسرائيليات لا نصدقها ولا نكذبها. It's coming to us from the people of the book. We do not believe it and we do not belie it. That is Samiri. Samiri is the character that convinced the children of Israel when Musa alayhi salam went to speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to collect all the gold that they took from Egypt, and he turned it into a golden calf. He was brought up by Jibreel. يعني هذه من الإسرائيليات. His mother giving him birth in the desert and nobody to take care of him. Allah sent to him Prophet Jibreel to take care of him. وَمُوسَى. And his name, by the way, was Musa too. Samiri, هذا is a laqab, title. And Musa, the one who was brought up by the Pharaoh, is a messenger. Musa الذي رباه فرعون رسول. And Musa is the one who was brought up by Jibreel. يا أخي, the son of Nuh. The son of Nuh. Nuh had a son who did not believe. إياك, dare you doubt that Nuh did not fulfill his obligation regarding educating his child about Islam. He taught the whole ummah. He will neglect his son. Amazing. He was not a Muslim. A Muslim. ونادى نوح الرب. And Nuh called upon his son when he was sailing in the ark, in the ship. فقال رب نبني من أهلي. My son is from my family. وإن وعدك الحق. You promise me to save my family. وأنت أحكم الحاكمين. Look what Allah told him. قال يا نوح. O نوح, إنه ليس من أهلك. He's not from your أهل. إنه الكسائي. إنه يعقوب الكسائي. إنه عمل غير صالح. إنه عمل غير صالح. نوح نبي. نوح. طب أولاد آدم. واتل عليهم نبأ ابني آدم بالحق. Today إن شاء الله في مسجد الإخلاص we're going to talk about this story بإذن الله تعالى. after Maghrib, a lecture there. Tell them, O Muhammad, the story of the two sons of Adam. One of them was righteous and the other one was a killer. طيب. فتوكل على الله. يعني, seek the means. You seek the means. You need to understand that the hearts of people, including your children, are in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن قلوب بني آدم بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. ف يعني سبحان الله, we told you before about the boy, غلام الأخدود. The whole country, the whole kingdom wanted him to be a sorcerer. And he ended up hearing the truth from one person. Look what happened. He ended up turning the whole kingdom to Islam. فتوكل على الله. يعني أصل الموضوع يعني ما, no guarantees. But the overall average, that if you are sincere, and then you seek the means, and then you are relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will deliver your child. Allah will deliver your child. Here is the third one, and I want to close with this. But this topic, inshallah, I will continue with it. Because we're approaching summer. I don't know, you probably planned already the summer of your children to go to the beach, Miami, or to go to Disneyland, or maybe to go to Hawaii. Have you ever thought about a summer camp where your children can learn about their deen? Did you plan already the beach for your children? Have you ever thought about what you're going to do regarding the education of your children next year? What are you going to do? Are you going to continue on that path? Should you change after this message? So inshallah, I will continue addressing this issue because we're approaching the summer. And to a lot of parents, is really something good that the school becomes the harbor for your child, maybe two-thirds of the day. And then you get your child 3 hours at the end of the day, you're so tired, you want to sleep. And you hardly want to talk to your child. He comes to talk to you, go watch television. We have to do something about it. كونوا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. Implement, أخي. Comes in the third piece, which I want to build on, inshallah, my next khutbah. Begin with you. الآباء فتنة. The parents are فتنة to the children. One of the most challenging thing that faced all the prophets from Nuh until Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is something that the scholar called sunnatul aba. Inna wajadna aba'ana ala ummah wa inna ala atharihim muhtadun. Wal aya al ukhra muqtadun. A messenger comes to the people, let's do this and this and this. The first thing that the people will face the messenger with, are you better than my father? You come now. Allah, akhi, subhanAllah, we know that some of the people in West Africa, I love them, by the way, they have that misunderstanding that Imam Malik, as he was standing in the salah, he used to, يعني the sunnah, we know that, هذا هو يعني الحديث, حديث ثابت. I'll never forget this day. I told the brother, I saw him praying and I said, أخي, you need to, يعني, تضع يدك على هكذا. Are you better than my tribe? أخي, it's not about my tribe or your tribe. But no, what he used here, he used his parents. And you know what? Shaitan knows that. Shaitan is very intelligent. Hadith Sabra ibn Abi al-Fakih. إن الشيطان قعد لابن آدم بأطرقه. الشيطان is sitting on the way to the son of Adam. Wherever he goes, look, قعد له في طريق الإسلام. When he wants to become a Muslim, whether complete Islam, from non-Islam to Islam, or to submit to the Quran and the Sunnah, and leave the hearsay, he will tell him what? أتسلم وتذر دينك ودين آبائك وآباء أبيك. ده كلام يا راجل. Are you going to leave your father and go and follow this guy who came from, Allah knows best, where did he come from? Come on, be wise, be smart.
يعني سبحان الله، حتى even شيطان was so intelligent to pass that message on to شياطين الإنس. A story that I always share with you, the death of Abi Talib. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling his uncle to become a Muslim, to say la ilaha illallah. Shaytan is inspiring Abu Jahl, Abdullah ibn Abi Umayyah. Ya Aba Talib, amillatu Abd al-Muttalib. You're going to leave the way of Abd al-Muttalib. You are a hindrance, you. Wallahi, I tell you, by Allah, lestu bihanith. You will not help your children if you do not help yourself. It doesn't make any sense that you tell your child to pray and you're not praying. Some of the amazing things that I notice in this community, that some parents bring their children to the weekend school, and it would be dhuhr time, and we're praying dhuhr. He's waiting in the car, waiting for his children to finish praying so he can pick him up. Let your child see you praying in the masjid, prostrate in front of him, recite the Quran, make dua. Brothers and sisters in Islam, begin with you. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, protect anfusakum first, yourself first, and then your family. Allahumma aslih dhurriyatina. اللهم أصلح ذرياتنا، اللهم أصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا أخرانا التي إليها معادنا، وأصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. قولوا قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.